Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I am going to prove that the slim cabinets nowadays, almost all the companies are making slim CPU cabinets, and I am going to prove that cabinets are made for the pro gamers and can be used by the pro gamers. I have seen most of the people, they are very worried that they have a slim cabinet and they cannot install graphic cards and cannot do their own mods in their CPU cabinets. So today's video is about that only, and I am the one that has done an own mod in my CPU cabinet. So I am going to show you guys my CPU cabinet and going to show you that which graphic card I have installed in 3, 2, 1. So guys, I am going to show you my CPU cabinet. Here you can see this is the slim one and a very small one. When I purchased this cabinet, I thought it is a CPU. You can see here from the back here. So now I am going to open the cover and going to show you this cabinet from inside. Again, you can see the front look. This is the CD driver, and here down you have the SD card port, the audio jack and two USB ports in the front. And at the back, here you have four USB ports, one HDMI cable and this VGA cable. And here is the graphic card one. Here you have this HDMI cable, and I use a connector of VGA to HDMI in this. And this is for the microphone, audio jack, and this I don't remember. And this is for connecting through LAN cable. So now I am going to show you by the via back camera the inside portion. 3, 2. So guys, finally our CPU is here, and I have opened this screw from here, you can see. And now I am going to open the back panel, you can see here. So on seeing this from the camera view, you might be thinking that it is a very complicated cabinet. Yes, I agree, it is a complicated cabinet. Here you have the RAM port, and here the second external RAM port. It is a main fan, and this is the graphic card. So this is the Gigabyte 1030 Ti. And this is a graphic card installed. I am not removing it just now. And you can see the most slim, I think it is the most slim graphic card designed by any company. And here I am going to show you the graphic card removed in 3, 2. So guys, finally here you can see the Gigabyte 1030 that I have taken out from my CPU. This is the HDMI port, the DVI port. And here you can see this from the back. It is a 2GB graphic card, you can see. And 2GB is of the computer by default. So after installing Gigabyte 1030, we have total 4GB. And here it has a fan with the heatsink, so there is no heating problem in the CPU. And here if we have to install it back, the fan is this side. We have to keep the fan this side and place this back. So guys, from my side, it will be my best opinion. If you want to choose any graphic card for a pro gamer wants to choose a graphic card for himself, he should directly choose Gigabyte 1030 without opening his eyes. Blindly faith, that we say. So guys, I have perfectly installed the graphic card back again, and already you guys have seen the cabinet. And now I am going to show you guys the performance on the computer screen in 3, 2, 1. So guys, I am on the computer screen, and I am going to show you the computer's performance when the graphic card is not installed. I have removed the graphic card, and I am going to open the task manager. And on opening the task manager, I am going on the performance. Here you can see Wi-Fi, disk, memory and CPU, not GPU. You can see here, and the memory is 3.9 GB, that is 4 GB no memory. So now I am going to quit this task manager, and here you can see Grand Theft Auto 4, GTA 4. I am clicking. So it has opened. The volume was too loud, sorry for that. And here you can see it has opened. In the starting it will be like that, the graphic card is installed, you can see this. And now it will show some error. And here you can see it is not responding. You can see nothing, only the cursor we can see here. And here you can see it is closed. So now I am going to show you the screen, that is the computer, when the graphic card is installed in 3, 2, 1. So guys, finally I have installed the graphic card back in the CPU, and I am showing you guys opening the task manager. And here in the performance you can see CPU, memory, disk and GPU also. NVIDIA GeForce 1030 GT 1030. Once again, NVIDIA GeForce GT 1030. And here you can see dedicated GPU memory storage 2GB, shared GPU memory storage 2GB. So it is a 2GB graphic card. So friends, I hope that I have tried my best to make you guys understand that a slim cabinet, or either to prove that a slim cabinet is also made for gamers, Gigabyte 1030 is the most best thing, or I can say that the most perfect graphic card for the gamers. It supports all the games and everything. My videos that you see on YouTube of GTA 4 are all on this, due to this Gigabyte 1030. You can see the graphics of the GTA 4 and guess what is Gigabyte 1030. So Gigabyte 1030 is a perfect graphic card, good graphic card, but it is very difficult to get this on a low price. I am going to tell you guys a short story. My elder brother bought this Gigabyte graphic card. I liked it graphics very much. I went to purchase the Gigabyte graphic card from the NASA market, and there I asked the person for this. He said it is unavailable, come after a week. Then I went again, he said come after a month. Then I went after a month, I made many calls to him, and during that time he said no, it is not available. In the end, after the total time of about 3 to 4 months, he said that the Gigabyte 1030 2GB low profile is available. Then I went there. Then again a shocking news I got, that the price has increased. My elder brother bought this 3 months before only for 6500, and I got it for 7850 something. And then adding on the HDMI to VGA converter, prices were different, the fitting charges were different. Then I had to install the window, it almost costed me around 8000. So guys, with this I would like to end the video. Stay home, stay safe. Till then, keep watching.